And seeing stuff.
What?
Donnie Darko was a film that I realized was too late for years later, so I was like, you know what, I'll just talk about this film in October because it's Halloween season. I'm glad I didn't do a years later on it because I'm still confused of what the film means. It has all these points and whatnot, and like time travel, helping people, fear, and like love, and it's like, what's the end game? What is Donnie Darko trying to say? I'm still confused by that, unless I just don't get it, but it seems like a bunch of messages or just kind of ideas that were just kind of floating around, and then it just kind of went to one, which is sacrifice, or at least I think sacrifice. So Donnie Darko, it's about this boy named Donnie who sees like a bunny or just a person in a bunny suit that has a bunch of glitter in its eyes. Comes up telling him that, hey, the apocalypse, the end of the world is coming in X amount of days, months, or whatever. And so it has a predestined arc throughout this whole movie. And so what does Donnie do? He, you know, is a normal high school kid. You know, he meets a girl, he messes with her, there's bullies, he goes to school, he meets Drew Barrymore. You know, that's really it. I feel like they could have done something with that, and instead it told a normal, average, everyday life of Donnie Darko that's seeing glimpses of bunnies. He's constantly getting told about clips and how he maybe see himself as the killer. I don't know. What I got out of this movie was a bunch of ideas, and then the filmmaker couldn't choose on one idea, whether it was the end of the world, about fear and love, about sacrifice, or something else I forget about. But like, I don't know, these things could work, but it just seems like, okay, we're gonna do everything and by the end we'll just choose one. So the theme of fear and love is brought up a couple of times in the film. I do think that that is tied into well with Donnie, where he fears and knows that the world's ending, it's coming to an end, and so he's scared because he doesn't know what to do. And he also fears what he might be. The last VFX shot or whatever, him holding his mirror or whatever, that was kind of weird, but him fearing that as well. But then loving this one girl at school whose name I just forgot about, but he has to make the ultimate choice of going to like a vortex, time traveling back into the first suit that he knew about the whole apocalypse thing, and he makes a sacrifice in dying because he fears of what is to come, but also loves this one girl, so he's willing to sacrifice himself in order to prevent the inevitable. And then even by the end of the movie, these visions go to different kids of the whole school, kind of background characters or just one scene characters. We see them in the last end credits of just seeing visions of the apocalypse or just that bunny suit or whatever. So like a cycle as well. The world wants to end, and it seems like it won't stop on Donnie since Donnie died cursed to all the other students, with them knowing that, hey, the world's gonna end, you're gonna have to deal with fear and love as well. That's what I've gathered. Donnie is going through school like any other kid. He's kind of bored at class, not really wanting to be there, but sees this girl he loves, and then that girl dies and all that stuff. So I don't know, man, it just sounds like I'm saying a bunch of bullshit, but I don't know, man, this movie is just kind of like, I like it, but it's got varied mixed messages, or not even messages, but themes throughout the film, where it's like, this is one, and then this is one, and then it's somehow not really connected by the end of the whole fear and love thing in this film. The film does date itself with the VFX shot. There's that, again, that mirror thing, and I am giving a lot of passes to this film in terms of the CG stuff. It looks fine for 2001, early 2000s. Like, you know, think of Jason X or like Leprechaun or whatever, the one that he goes to space, those look bad. But early 2000s VFX CGI shots, this looks fine. Nowadays, it looks a bit wonky, but it's fine. And then another kind of line or just kind of scene that dates this film is that go back to China line. It's definitely not a 2020, 2021 film. Did chuckle, just be like, oh yeah, this is definitely, you know, not a film gonna come out nowadays and people are gonna be fine with it. And then going back to time travel, apparently there's like this vortex, unless I missed it, but apparently, or maybe Donnie summoned it, who knows, but there's just like this vortex time travel-esque kind of MacGuffin where he realizes that his girl that he loves dies, the apocalypse is like coming up on its day. So he's like, you know what, time travel time, and he's gonna make that sacrifice and die with that pod lands into his house. Also another thing, the reason why he didn't get killed that first time around is because he likes sleepwalking. He wakes up like a golf club and everything. I guess that adds to the whole mystique of him maybe being the killer or maybe going around doing these things, because he sleepwalks, he doesn't remember anything about these sleepwalks at all. And then Drew Barrymore's character, she's kind of aligned with the whole genocide kind of themes of it, where the apocalypse, genocide, all that stuff. And I think there's a line where she says that there needs to be like a reset for the school because she doesn't have faith in these kids being in the school, being helpful, being just good kids or whatever. Like, she doesn't have any faith in that, and she wants a big reset that aligns with the whole apocalypse, where maybe this apocalypse is needed because there needs to be genocide to reset everything because the whole world is all messed up. And I like that. In the end, Drew Barrymore just kind of gives up as like, you know what, sure, whatever, let it all burn down. But I think that's kind of one of the issues, where there's this impending doom, this apocalypse, themes of fear and love, sacrifice, genocide is brought up, and then in the end they didn't do it. Essentially it felt like a cop-out, being like, oh, guess what, there's a cycle of dreams that kids are gonna have, where about this bunny guy or this bunny suit thing. Eventually teenager, all the kids in this little town or whatever going to know that the apocalypse is coming and they have to prevent it somehow, or be just like Donnie where it's like, you know what, I'm sleepwalking and maybe being a criminal, who knows. So I guess the reason why I can't really get behind this film is the fact that they have this setup about the apocalypse, about this doom that's gonna happen, and Donnie knows this, and instead of preventing, well, I guess he tries to, but, and then instead of the film diving more into that, instead it goes into the whole high school stuff, a little bit of melodrama stuff, he likes his girl, and the Indian is like, you know what, I guess because this girl died, I'll make this sacrifice because I love her, and then he fears that the world's gonna end. So there's this MacGuffin time travel vortex stuff that comes back around, time travels back 28 or 29 days earlier, only to die because he loves his girl, and then in the end this girl doesn't know what happened, and then this cycle of knowing this apocalypse is gonna be passed around to all these kids, but then that feels like a cop-out because you have this setup of the apocalypse. And I think the film would have been better if the apocalypse had been done, like everyone dies, because Drew Barrymore's character, she wants a big reset about the whole school, which imitates the whole genocide and apocalypse thing. It seems like most of the kids in the film don't really seem happy, like everyone's just kind of giving up, which is, you know what, you know, just going through life or whatever. Family dynamic between Donnie and his family is awkward but weird on purpose because things are a bit shaky in that family. So I think it would have been served better as, you know, all this stuff happening being a whole big reset thing, and then by the end Donnie knows this but he can't prevent it, and then the apocalypse happens, but instead it's like, you know what, we're gonna cop that out because, you know, we want like a happier ending or just kind of a confusing ending, because I was confused by the end. I was like, wait a minute, so they didn't do the apocalypse, the film just basically was like, you know what, screw that ending, we'll just go with the whole psycho dream curse type of ending, which is like, eh, all right. So in the end, Donnie Darko, while I like aspects of it and I think I would have liked it much better with a different ending, overall the film is okay. Like, I like the film, but I don't know, there is a bit too much of the whole high school stuff as well, so the film's all right, but I do like it potential, but there's too many kind of themes and messages being thrown around, and then by the end just to have a very underwhelming kind of result was a bit disappointing. So that's it for me. This has been The Road So Far, and thank you for watching.